So, since you're already aware about, the content, I mean, about the course name, this is packet analysis, with Wireshark Analyzer. I hope you understand, right? This is like, the training, of the Wireshark here, how we are going to capture packets and how we are going to analysis, right? Those packets. This is all about about the packet tracer here. So this is the course outline in front of you. You can see, like, the first section, the second section, third and fourth sections we have here, right? This is. So these are the sections that we have to cover in the basic, right, Mr. Prince? The basic, not advanced level, because we have to start this training from the basic level. We have to understand the basic concept first, right? The basic concept of a Wireshark, and then we have to jump to the next level, which is advanced Wireshark, right? Advanced packet analysis, you can say, with the Wireshark analyzer, right, Mr. Prince?
Yes, I'm with you.
Okay, that's wonderful, sir. So you can see introduction and operation of Wireshark, live captures and live capture settings, display options and basic interpretations, working with display filters and capture filters, and lots of here, the preferences, the user profile, the name resolution. So I mean, it's all about the properties of Wireshark from this point, to the next point. This is all about the property of the Wireshark. So you are here to understand the property of the Wireshark from the beginning. And that's why this course is the basic level course. This is the first level course, I can say. And after this, after completing 3 days, right? So what I'm going to teach you what advanced level of Wireshark. But today I have, introduction and operation of Wireshark, live captures and live capture settings, display options and basic interpretations, working with display filters and capture filters. So I'm going to give you only examples here. What is display filters and what is capture filters, file input and output, right? So these are the things that we are going to cover today, right? So I hope you have this content with you. So we have a 4 modules here, right? So we are going to follow this particular module, right? So before starting, I would like to know from you, do you have any question?
No question from the introduction you've given. No, so
Yeah,
please
so
go ahead, please.
thank you very much, Prince. So introduction is very easy. What we have to do, we have to start from the introductions, and the operation of what Wireshark. So I would like to teach you from one picture. So let me share the picture with you. Wireshark and the Wireshark pictures here. This is. So in this, you can see, right? In this, you can see some, the topics is here. Let's take an example. What is, the Wireshark here? Mr. Prince, try to understand in this topology, in this particular picture, right? You are going to understand, this one, introduction and operation of Wireshark. Right, Mr. Prince? In this picture, you are going to learn introduction and operation of Wireshark. Okay. So do you have any understanding, of this picture? Are you able to explain something from this picture, Mr. Prince?
Okay, so yeah, so yes, I can. Yeah, so you have the graphical user interface. It takes you to the core, but then you capture then yes,
Right.
I see what you've written, but to understand,
Right.
no, I don't have a background.
Oh, wait a minute, I'll tell you. See, this is basically the operation. First of all, I would like to tell you, in any organization, right, we have some network engineers. Right, sir. Network engineers. You can see here, this is network engineer. Network engineer responsibility in an organization. Let's say this is your organization, Mr. Prince, right? This is. right? This is your organization. In this organization, sir, your responsibility is to manage your network. Am I right? Your responsibility is to manage your network because you are a network engineer. You know, let's take an example. If I say deploy, deploy is a responsibility of a network engineer. Let's say you want to deploy a switch, you want to deploy a router, you want to deploy access point, or you want to deploy wireless controller, you want to deploy a firewall. Whatever you have, if you want to deploy even a server, printer, scanner, it is your responsibility, Mr. Prince. Agree? This is your responsibility.
I agree, yes.
So once you deploy, let's take an example. Once you deploy, you have to monitor also, right? You have to monitor this thing also. Okay, I deploy and I have to monitor it. Because you are a network engineer, your responsibility is to deploy, is to monitor. Let's take an example. And some other parameters also. You're also responsible. Let's take an example like deploy, monitor, and for troubleshoot. Troubleshoot is also your responsibility. If you able to troubleshoot, let's take an example. So you are going to troubleshoot your router. You're going to troubleshoot switches. You have access point in your company. Maybe you have a wireless controller. You have a firewall in your company. So you can see here under the troubleshoot, your responsibility is to troubleshoot those devices, right, Mr. Prince? So basically for troubleshooting these devices, definitely you have to depend on some applications. Am I right? You have to depend on the application if you want to troubleshoot your router. So lots of people are using, let's say, Ping. Lots of people are using TraceRoute. Lots of people are using TraceCert and Syslog and SNMP and etc. Right, Mr. Prince? Agree?
Yes, I agree.
Right. So you are network engineer. You can see your office here. Your office is here. In your office, you are going to deploy. Right. Let's say you purchase a new access point. So it is your responsibility is to deploy this access point in your company and you are always ready. But once you deploy, you have to keep eyes on that particular AP. It is called like monitor. Once you are able to monitor, definitely the next step is you want to troubleshoot it. The reason is sometime you are going to delete devices. Sometime you are going to deploy some devices. Sometime you want to make a changes on the devices and then troubleshooting start. And you can see from the blue color, you're using application, Ping, TraceRoute, Tracer, Syslog, SNMP, and etc. But some external application also, like Syslog, no, like SolarWinds. Some people use SolarWinds. Let's take an example for troubleshooting. Some people use Insider for troubleshooting. Some people use MeterGeek also for troubleshooting. Right, Mr. Prince? I hope you understand. Like you have the CLI utility and you also have, you know, the graphical user interface utility also. Clear? Okay.
Yes.
You have the graphical user interface. Like, you know, Mr. Prince, we have a lots of organization, right? Lots of. It depends on the organization. Some organization is using SolarWinds. Some is using Insider. Some is using, you know, MeterGeek. Someone is using Microsoft, let's say, Netmon. Some organization using Wireshark, right? Some organization using PRTG. Network monitoring, it depends actually. So as a good network engineer, it is your responsibility, right, is to troubleshoot your network. And these are what applications. Some are CLI based, like ping, tracer, you know, tracer, syslog. Let's take an example. You can make your router. I mean, you can log, let's say of routers, logs, let's say of switch, logs. Let's take an example of WLC, right? And these log is basically what events. This is called system events where. So lots of options are available for the troubleshooting. We can start our troubleshooting from basic to advanced level, and then we can start. Even, Mr. Prince, if you want to troubleshoot, let's take an example. I will give you an idea. If you want to troubleshoot, right, let's say something, I think you have to start, from some application like ping, tracer, you know, syslogs, SNMP and all. But if you're using some time, you are going to execute some commands also for troubleshooting, right? For commands also. I mean, overall, what is your experience? Your experience is to troubleshoot something, and for that, you have to depend on the ping, on the trace route, on the tracer, on the syslog and SNMP. And sometime you have to depend on some application, which is third-party application. SolarWinds is a third-party application. Insider is also third-party. MeterGeek is also third-party. Netmon is also third-party. And Wireshark PRTG is also what? Third-party. Right, sir? Right, Mr. Prince? I hope you understand. So, thousand of organization,
yes,
is using what different applications here, and you can see it's a very good and wonderful examples here, you know, for this one, right? This one. So SolarWinds, Insider, MeterGeek, Netmon, Wireshark, PRTG, and lots of others applications are available. Let's say TCPI is also there, right? Ping Plotter is also there. Let's take an example. Ping Plotter is also there. It depends. So because every company have a devices like routers, switches, access point, WLC, firewall, and you can also write like server is also there, right? Server is also there. So it is the responsibility of network engineer is to troubleshoot. Now, are you going to troubleshoot router? You have to say, Mr. Peter, yes, you are going to troubleshoot what? A router here, right? You're going to troubleshoot router. But let's take an example. You have so much protocol, like CDP is a protocol. Trunk is a protocol. VLAN is a protocol. VTP is a protocol. EIGRP is a protocol. OSPF is a protocol, right? Okay. And lots of protocol also. Let's say interfaces are there. So I hope you understand, Mr. Prince, if we want to troubleshoot, we have to troubleshoot CDP, right? We have to troubleshoot, like say, trunk, VLANs. We have to troubleshoot EIGRP, OSPF, and the interfaces. From the access point, we have to troubleshoot, let's say, the coverage area, right? We have to troubleshoot the radio frequency. We have to troubleshoot RSSI. We have to troubleshoot SNR. I mean to say, lots of devices have their own responsibility. Clear, sir? I hope you understand. Mr. Prince, every device has their own responsibility, right? If we want to troubleshoot wireless network or if we want to troubleshoot Ethernet network, it depends. Sometime, Mr. Prince, right, if I give you a chance, you have to start your troubleshooting from the cable, from the connector, right or not? From the cable, from the connector. Might be the cable is faulty. Might be the connector is faulty. Sometime your interface goes down. Sometime your interface goes up. Am I right, Mr. Prince? So as an engineer, Mr. Prince, it is your responsibility to troubleshoot all your network, right? Using the devices and applications, the third-party applications also. Because I told you, like million of organization is using Wireshark, but Wireshark is not only the sniffering tool we have. We have lots of tools actually, right? Which is going to help us in troubleshooting. Now the question is: do you want to troubleshoot Ethernet technology or do you want to troubleshoot wireless technologies? Right? If you want to troubleshoot wireless technology, you are going to troubleshoot AP coverage, radio frequency, SNR, you know, the RSSI, these are the terms actually that you are going to use it. Okay.